grazing round. Dingoes are howling far across the plain. Western breezes sighing through the golden grain. I'm riding down the valley that I love. Glad I settled down and made my home. Those years were not in vain when the pioneers reigned. Cause I'm riding down the valley that I love.
Buddy Williams was born in Sydney's Newtown 61 years ago. Like so many World War I babies, his birth was celebrated by a trip direct to an orphanage, in Buddy's case in Glebe. It's probably appropriate that a kid who never knew a home would grow up to see the road as the only home he ever knew.
When I'm in the saddle, I'm swinging on my throne, cause I'm riding down the valley that I love.
Some neighbours of ours just over the next farm in Dorigo had a gramophone, and they used to play some of the old Jimmy Rogers records, and that's where I sort of got the liking for this type of music. I mean, right in those days when I was young, and it was a thing with me that I wanted to become a cowboy singer. I had all the other sort of pretences. I suppose I was a natural cowboy. I mean, I'd worked on the farm and done that sort of thing, but to sing a cowboy song, well, that was something I had to learn about.
Put it there, bud, even though it does wear a hat.
This is Buddy, Mother.
My daughter has often spoken about you. I am pleased to meet you, Mr. Williams.
Dad, I want you to meet Buddy.
I know, the singing cowboy.
30 years ago, the singing cowboy made his first movie, right here in Australia.
You're just as I pictured you, Mr. McCackle. Tall, rugged, a real man of the outback.
Well, I must say, you're a bit different to what I expected.
Well, let's go in for some tea.
Unfortunately, Buddy's first movie was also his last, which was probably a very lucky thing for Gene Autry.
That song to everything that was in my heart, Mavis. Glad we got round your father to agree to our marriage.
Yes, Buddy.
At first I thought he was going to eat my head off when I popped the question.
Dad's bark's worse than his bite. Still, I'm glad we got round him.
I suppose the radio people will announce me now as the singing rooster, or some such thing.
To me, you'll always be my singing cowboy.
Don't blame me, blame the singing cowboy.
Buddy mightn't have made it to Hollywood, but he went on to make 500 records and more fans and more real friends than anyone else in the history of the Australian recording and entertainment industry.
RCA, ladies and gentlemen, making a presentation of Buddy's new album and a plaque on behalf of the RCA record people. And the Buddy Williams album, Without Friends, What a Dreary World This Would Be, is now available right around Australia from your record store. This is the Buddy Williams.
The Buddy Williams Show travels with young country musos from all over Australia. No matter where they've come from, they're going to places they never even knew existed. Like Kirk Steel from Kalgoorlie, Lawrie Minson from Tamworth, Fiddling Paul Jenkins from Armidale, and Smiling Tim Palmer all the way from Hobart. They all know where they come from, and they all know where they've been, but they've got no idea where they're going.
Well, I can find one to hold me tight, but I can never make believe it's all right. No, no, 6 days on the road, and I'm gonna make it home tonight.
These fellas are about the last white people you're going to see for a while, because from here on in, the Buddy Williams Show is visiting Aboriginal missions and communities, a different one every day.
Logbook's way behind. But
I'm gonna make it home tonight.
If you live anywhere in the bush, these blokes have just been through your town, or they're on their way. But if you live in the city, you'll probably never see them again, because the city's the one place they're not going.
Well, now my hometown's a coming inside. If you think I'm a happy, you're right. 6 days on the road, I'm gonna make it home tonight.
To give you an idea, in an average year, Buddy and his boys will see 230 towns and travel over 100,000 kilometres. For example, this tour, this is where they've been so far, and this is where we're going with them. Right up to Cape York and down the other side. When you travel north from Cairns and you've got to do a show in a different Aboriginal community every night, there's only one way to go, and that's by plane. There are roads, but if you went that way, it'd take you a month of Sundays. I know the Leyland brothers have done it, but they didn't have to sing their way around every night. Old Buddy, he just can't take the risk of getting bogged. He's got some songs he's just got to sing. You've all heard about the Flying Doctor. Well, what you're watching now is the Flying Cowboy.
He was born a Sydney orphan around 50 years ago, and spent his early childhood on a farm in Dorigo. But he left his home to wander on the rocky road to fame. Now he is a legend, Buddy Williams is his name. He's traveling round Australia by truck and caravan, taking country music when and where he can. The people come for miles around to listen to the show and save their wild applause for the man from Dorigo.
Deviant part of the show, mate.
I'm the musician of the band.
Kirk, how'd you get involved with Buddy, mate? What do you do apart from, you know, give all the kids the wrong idea about music? Did you think he was any good?
Yeah!
You didn't think he was a bit dirty and, you know?
Yeah!
How'd you get involved with Buddy, mate?
Through Lawrie, really. Banjo player.
And what were you doing before, mate?
I was just cruising around. I went through Tamworth a couple of times. I went out with another couple of shows. Oh. And just happened to be in Geraldton, playing in a rock and roll band. Got a phone call. Need someone. Here I am.
And mate, when you travel around Australia, is it as you expected it, or...?
No, nothing like it, actually. Like... Well, the territory, you know, I expected to be desert.
Right.
And that's not. It's bigger than I thought. Like, I thought I'd been around it before. But here I am, somewhere where I've never been, again.
And when you get to a town like this, does it feel good when you see all the kids gather around and get excited about you, right?
Well, that's why I'm back doing it again,
really. Okay, how many of you kids are coming tonight?
Yes!
Now, you've got to put your hand up if you're coming. Everyone's coming. Hey, would you like Kirk to do one more dirty song?
Yes!
With his organ?
Yes!
Okay, Kirk, just give him one, mate. We'll see you tonight, eh?
You know, between us, Buddy's had a bird who's been following him all around Australia for over 30 years. She's probably Australia's first roadie. But she also happens to be Buddy's wife and number one fan, the amazing Grace.
Actually, I mean, she didn't like country music at all. But she used to do ballroom dancing and demonstrations and things like that. I mean, she had a touch of the flair for show business. A lot of difference to being anything to do with country music. And when she first met me and was introduced, and she said, "Oh, pleased to meet you, Mr. Rogers." That, well, she must have known that Jimmy Rogers was all the go in the rage at that time, and I mean, that's how much she took notice of me. She said, "Oh, pleased to meet you, Mr. Rogers." Well, I said, "Williams is the name." Oh, yes, it was great fun. I mean, from there on, she, all the way, I mean, I say, she sort of stuck with me, I mean, and worked with me. And we've made it a team, I think.
All tickets over here, please.
Remember, Buddy and his boys aren't playing at the Opera House or even the local town hall. They go anywhere and they play anywhere, under trees, on the backs of trucks, and only when they're very lucky, somewhere as sophisticated as this, under a school. Sometimes the music's so foot-tapping, some of the audience just can't help themselves. They can't dance either. Before fiddling, Paul Jenkins started fiddling with the Buddy Williams Band. He was a classical violinist. Naturally, being a fine classical violinist in Australia, he became 15th in charge of selling train tickets in Tamworth. Now he's with Buddy Williams, he reckons the pay's a lot better, but the hours aren't as good. As we can figure, this is the 8,280th time that Buddy has said goodnight to his audience.
That is all, folks.
And one thing you can bet on is that tomorrow will be the 8,281st time.
Until we meet you all again, good luck to each and every one of you. Look after yourself, won't you? Be kind to each other. Be careful. And if you see someone without a smile on their face, give them one of yours. We'll see ya. Ta-da.
The Aboriginal people, I mean, very shy sort of people, and we've noticed, I mean, to say they like to sort of hang back in the shadows a bit, but they still love country music. I mean, they can sit there and they absorb it. It seems to be a part of their lifestyle, I think, culture.
Buddy, after the show's over, how do you really feel, mate?
Oh, I feel great, John, really do. I do this, you know, 6 nights a week for 11 months of the year. And I've been doing it for 40 years. And I only hope that there's another 40 years left for me to do the same thing.
You still enjoy it now as much as when you first hit the road?
Oh, yes, I still enjoy it. Music, I've loved it all my life. I've dedicated my life to country music. And I certainly do still enjoy it.
Another day doesn't actually mean getting up and reading the reviews in the papers. It means getting up, loading and unloading the planes and setting up all over again. Buddy's type of show could only happen here in Australia.
Coming up on the outside, we got
and for that matter, where else could a horse race like this happen?
Again. And Percy, Bernard on Steel goes to the lead. Don Cubitt picks up Nugget in the tail. Nugget's got the lead again. Long Eye on his tail. And there goes Steel around the outside. It's a close race. I think at the moment it's Steel by nose, Nugget, and then here comes Bainett on the outside. Bainett's taking a lead, and he's away. Coming around the line straight away, they're all together. And we've been a fall, and we've got Wong Eye coming into the lead. And it's Wong Eye for the Birmingham Cup. Second, Dundas. Third, Bainett. You're right down there, Silver. Right, he's right. Not too badly hurt, a tough young fella. Took Saddle and all with him.
Well, Bud, we're here. Where are we?
Well, you're at Bamaga now, John. Gone as far as we can go in Australia. Right at the top.
You've been here before, mate?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've been here before, all right.
Look, it doesn't seem like we're in part of Australia, mate, when we're looking around here.
Well, I mean to say, I suppose we're only just, an hour trip by boat from Thursday Island. I mean to say, the island people mainly over this part of the country. Well, I mean, it's only cost you $10 on the boat, and I mean to say, that's not much today, is it? And they get here within an hour. Instead of us having to go to them, I just flip over and usually patronise when we come to Bamaga.
Yeah, how do you reckon you go tonight, mate?
Well, I never ever worry too much because most of the island people, they seem to love country music and guitars, and I reckon it'll be pretty good.
Good evening and welcome to the Buddy Williams Show. We've got a big show for you tonight, and first off, we'd like you to give a big, warm Bamaga welcome, a living legend in Australian country music, Mr. Buddy Williams.
I'm gonna buy me an old plane, ride all over this town. Gonna ride till I find that baby I love.
On the road there, and a mate on the road working gang having a go at me one day, and he bet me on the side that I wouldn't be game to sing on the street. That was the sort of turning point for me, because I sort of analysed the whole thing, and I said, well, if people are going to pay freely, I mean to say, for me to sing songs and just throw it in the hat, I said, that'll do me, because I knocked out 13 towns, 7 and 6 in just a matter of an hour or something like that while I was on the street corner in Coffs Harbour.
I'll get my erratic way to settle down and be true to that curly-headed girl. Take that, take it. I'm
pretty conchy today?
Love affair at the moment.
You spend most time practicing out there, right?
Oh, yeah. When I get the time.
I notice everywhere we're going, you seem to wander off on your own and strum away. Are you creating new masterpieces or just practicing?
I get a lot of satisfaction out of just sitting down playing to myself. You know, that's what music, you know, is all about. It's satisfying something in you.
We're not going to get a great new masterpiece like Marlene's My Darling. Now, how did you get the inspiration for a song like
Marlene? That one.
How long did it take you to write a song like that?
10 minutes.
Really? Music and words?
Yeah.
Have you got any others as good as that?
There's a few, but they're not quite as good as that.
Is there any Marlenes here? Are you a Marlene? I bet she's a Marlene. Look, there's a Marlene, Nelly. If there's any Marlenes here, don't take offence because it's not meant to. If you are big, fat and ugly, don't worry about it.
We've got one down there somewhere.
Yeah, I know. I heard a laugh there, a screaming, yowry laugh. It was a Marlene laugh. Well, this is from all the Marlenes in the audience anyway. Marlene, you were my darling.
Oh, Marlene was my darling. She had long blonde hair and she was so fair. She said, come to me, what can you see when you look into my eyes? I said, Marlene, you're my darling. You're the biggest girl I've ever known. But your eyes say that you don't love me. So I think it's time I was going home. She said, honey.
Honey?
My pretty baby.
My pretty baby.
How could you say those
things
to me?
How could you say those things to me?
You know that I never love.
I'll never love another.
Please don't say.
Please don't leave me.
I said, Marlene, you're my darling. You're the biggest and fattest, ugliest girl I've ever known. But your eyes say that you don't love me. So I think it's time I was going home. She started crying. Said she wasn't lying.
I'm not bloody lying.
Said she loved me. And no one else.
I love you. No, I'm not going to say that.
I could tell. By the way, she said it, that I was just another scratch along the shelf. So I said, Marlene, you're my darling.
You're my darling.
You were the biggest girl I've ever known. But your eyes say that you don't love me. So I think it's time I was going home. Thank you.
How do you combine this, you know, your serious musicianship with the rather ludicrous lyrics?
Oh, that sort of only came into it when the show got going, because this, like, the show's pretty crazy anyway, you know, and I just sort of went along with, I mean, you know, Buddy's pretty crazy, so you just sort of, you go like it after a while, you start going, oh.
Sunday is the only day of rest for Buddy and the boys, except they don't rest. Today they put on a free concert south of Weeper. What else are you going to do in Weeper on a Sunday anyway?
Don't you throw that. Don't.
No matter how much fun these guys are having, you've got to remember they work a 7-day week, 16 hours a day. If they didn't have fun, they'd go crazy, which they probably already are anyway.
Good day.
Come to the show? Come last night, I think, didn't you?
Yeah,
cowboy.
Did you? You were there last night. You can't remember. Can you? And he's shy. There you go. Talking today. No?
If If you think sometimes it all seems like a backyard concert, it's because really that's what it is. It's like Buddy and the boys arriving in someone's home, saying good day, cracking a few jokes, and then standing up and singing a few songs. It might be very un-Rolling Stones, but it is very Australian. Often, in an Aboriginal town, you think no one's going to come to the concert. In this case, the concert wasn't advertised, so no one knew it was on. But as soon as the music starts, the people start to come from everywhere. Pull up a bit of shade, sit down, start to enjoy themselves. It's sort of like Buddy Williams as the Aborigines' very own Pied Piper.
I still reckon I'd do the same thing over again. I've had a lot of ups and downs with it. I've had some good times and bad, and I've just taken them in my stride. But I don't think I could have managed that without a good partner. I don't honestly think I could have done it.
Are there any country towns in Australia you've missed out on?
Very few. They're not worth going to, I'd reckon, the ones that I've missed.
We'd like to get you to give a big, warm Jessica Point welcome to a living legend in Australian country music, Mr. Buddy Williams.
To give you an idea of Buddy's popularity with the Aborigines, say there are 600 living in a town. You can expect around 600 of the 600 to turn up at the concert.
A little bit of mucking about for the kids. I'd like to do this song. It's one of the early cowboy songs I wrote years ago. Real Australian song. There's a spot that's near and dear to me. Back there's where I long to be. Man could never find a better home. I'm going back there, I'll stay, where I'm free from day to day. Way out where the white-faced cattle roam. I'm going back there, I'll stay, where I'm free from day to day. Way out where the white-faced cattle roam. Just for the kids now. Blue gum trees blowing in the evening breeze, where the bees are building honeycomb. I love to drink from the rippling stream by the old bar cup where the campfires gleam, way out where the white-faced cattle roam.
In Queensland at least, the Aboriginal kids are as happy and healthy and fun-loving as you'd ever hope to find, just like your kids. But just like our kids, they can't resist a bit of the old Elvis Presley twist.
Goes proud and howl a mournful moan. When the jackass laughs in the early morn, it means another day is born. Way out where the white-faced cattle roam. Way out where the white-faced cattle roam. Way out where the white-faced cattle roam.
Yep. Thank you.
Well, Grace, another day, another dollar. How's it feel after all these years being on the road, moving on to another town?
Wonderful. Feel as good as I did the day I started.
You really do?
I mightn't look it, but I feel it.
Tell me, how did it start?
How did it start? Oh, well, you know, in the war years, and the fella came along with the name of Buddy Williams and spoke to me very cheeky. That was it.
Was he on the road at the time?
No, he was in the army.
Yeah, so...
Fighting for his country.
Yeah.
What trying to.
So you hung around and would you marry him during the war or after?
No, just after.
And you hit the road then?
Yeah, oh, well, shortly after that, yes. We started out with a tent show, a rodeo.
And do you see the Buddy Williams show going on forever or do you see...
Well, I think so. See, the doctors have told him he's got to stop, but he won't stop. He said he's got to die someday, so he might as well die doing what he likes doing. or what he loves doing, or what he's made his life.
When you're on the road, a long, long way from home, the words to some songs mean more than others.
I pity the mother and the father when the children are gone. Their lives were complete, still they must carry on. So many families separated today. Still I pity the mother and the father when the kids move away. They want it so bad for you to have it good. Didn't they give you everything? They did the best they could. Still they know that you must move away, have a family of your own. Still I pity the mother and the father when the children are gone. No welfare check or government plan can ease the pain in the heart of a lonely man, or the lonely woman who gave her all you might live today. I pity the mother and the father when the kids move away.
If you've been listening to the words, I think you'll understand why the guys look as wistful as they do. They're a long way from home, and they know tomorrow they're going to be further away still.
In olden days, a family never strayed too far from home. One or two might move away, the rest would carry on. But we are scattered to the wind in this old world today. And I pity the mother and the father when the kids move away. No miracle drugs in a nursing home can say I love you, mommy and daddy, when you're all alone. Oh, lonely woman who gave her all that you might live today. I pity the mother and the father when the kids move away. Yes, I pity the mother and the father when the kids move away.
When you're on the road, guests do not stay at the Hilton Hotel or drive Avis rental cars. The group sleeps under the stars, or when they're very lucky, with a roof over their heads and a mattress thrown on the floor.
Come on.
Shit.
Hey, get up. Kirk? You awake? Yeah.
You are. Well, it's time to get up.
Come on. Oh, they're a great batch of boys. Yeah.
And do you have to look
after
them?
Oh, I think they keep us going too. Make us feel young.
And do you treat them as part of the family?
More or less, yes. Well, they all call me mum or mother or something, so I've mothered a lot of them around the country.
Oh, well, at least it's air-conditioned. And there is a sort of room service.
Terrible place to try and do with a cooker. There's not even a kettle in the joint. I don't know. Oh, well, cup of tea and toast this morning.
We'd have to put up with a stove.
That's what I say. The blooming jug blew up.
Yeah, pity these boys wouldn't have cleaned these up last night.
Oh, well.
Leave them, I suppose.
Heck! Did you leave these dishes? Just get yourself in here. See any washing up detergent?
Well, this is shocking, isn't it?
Sure, man.
That looks so happy this morning.
Yeah,
breakfast with Buddy and the band isn't just breakfast. It's sort of an Outback Musos board meeting as well. They talk about last night, tonight, and tomorrow night. And also the fact the toast is burnt.
We'll pour it on
you. What about last night, do you reckon? One of the worst nights we've had?
Yeah.
But, I don't know, something wrong with the power plant, do you reckon?
Yeah, well, 185 volts, you reckon?
60 volts, ain't it?
Distorted everything. Mm. Everything with sound was distorted.
Oh, I'm empty, full bore.
Yeah.
Full bore. Pour it up.
Singing in the rain.
Where are we going today, Kate?
Edward River.
You know how far it is?
Get up now.
Every place we went in the north of Queensland was more beautiful than the last. But wherever you go in Australia or the world, there really isn't any place like home, especially when you're not home. Next stop is Aurukun International Airport, where no Concords fly. As usual, there'll be the horde of screaming fans, fleets of black limousines, and naturally a press conference with the usual fawning radio and television journalists. Well, at least someone's in a truck.
Be careful of that crummy Martin guitar.
We'll be back as soon as the rain stops, so if you want to hang around.
We'll be back.
We'll persevere. We'll play in the rain if we have to.
And after all the travelling and all the setting up, it goes and rains.
Well, me and Buddy are going to keep playing anyway, so if you want to stick around, we'll go for it.
But as they say in Aurukun, the show must go on, eh?
I see you've all found your umbrellas, eh? Under the trees at last, eh?
Yeah.
That's bad luck that we got this rain tonight, isn't it? Never mind. If you can stand it, well, we'll stand here and do a bit of country music for you, after all, I suppose. I've got a lot of friends here that came along to see me, and it's only fair that I should sing some songs for you. The rain might take up and we'll be able to continue with the show anyway.
I ought to point out, the reason the other guys ducked off isn't because they're scared of getting wet. It's just because they're scared of getting electrocuted. Which might be good entertainment tonight, but not so good for tomorrow night.
He knew he was going to go, for he reached out and licked at my hand.
I've never ever felt that I have achieved anything yet. The best years of my life, I think, are gone as far as the business is concerned. I think I became too involved with getting out to the people all the time in the bush. I mean, it's and city life, I've never been able to accept it. I never ever liked it. And I think you've got to be in the city where it's happening, I mean, say, to get this recognition that we speak of.
But if dogs have a heaven, there's one thing I know. Old Shep has a wonderful home.
Ever see yourself retiring?
Well, I've always said that to retire, I mean, to say you might as well be in your coffin anyway. I think you're dead. I mean, so we've only got one life. We might as well make the best of it. After all, I mean, I don't feel that I'm crook. If I feel that I'm going to get crook, well, I mean, I'd take it easy then. But I just sort of play it how I feel. I feel okay.
So for the next,
I mightn't look okay, but I feel okay.
So for whatever time that there is left of Buddy Williams, you'll be on the road?
Well, I think while ever I've got health, I'll be there. And the people, of course, if they still keep on buying Buddy Williams records like they are still doing, well, I mean, I think I'll be there for a while yet.
Do you ever think of settling down, Grace, when you're wandering around Australia?
No,
you must have been
don't
everywhere.
Ask me.
I'm going to ask you, of all the places...
I haven't found the right place yet. They're still all, I can't
Etten?
Make up my mind.
What about Etten?
No, Powers? Thank you, no.
Oh, I'm just a wandering man.
I do like Cairns, though.
Never even think about settling down.
Might be Cairns.
Bamingham. That's the highest...
That's a good spot.
Yeah. That's the top in country and Western music in Australia, mate. The top gig.
What are the bad things?
Oh, just things, you know, like...
like someone dropping his fiddly-diddly.
Yeah. Bastards drop me violin all the time off the amplifiers.
Yeah, like having about three or four bad shows in a row and Buddy won't pay you at the end of the week and you're in Alice Springs and
like
you
that,
can't get out of the place.
And getting bogged for 6 weeks in a row, you know, you'd move 10 miles and move 10 miles in a day, you know, like we did coming up through South Australia.
Starving to death.
How do these guys compare to other groups you must have travelled with over the last 40 years, huh?
Oh, incomparably better, naturally.
Are they getting silly?
Sorry,
all
Buddy.
The time?
Oh, I think they're...
this better be good.
These guys are pretty with it. Like, you know, I mean...
Cool.
With a lot of fellas we've had, I mean... haven't been as silly as these fellas.
You've let us down.
These guys hanging together all right?
Well, so far, I've been very good. But,
no suicides yet.
We've had a problem or two. In the early part of the year.
No name dropping
there. I nearly lost Kirk on this trip like a raccoon.
Do you lose many musos who go to a town and really dig it and stay there?
Oh, we have from time to time. Mostly they dig the women.
sometimes the women dig them too much, you know.
Now, how have you found living together like about the time you've been travelling? Has it been like you thought, Lawrie?
Well, I've seen more of Paul than I've ever seen before.
How many autographs have you signed, Tim?
Oh.
He counts them.
This is a serious show.
Oh, yeah. He's got to run to himself. Not me. Oh, my God.
That was mine.
That's really been good.
Come on, buddy, give us a song.
Come on, buddy, give us a song.
We
We cowboys will always roam, so I'm here. And though it may look so strange, have no fear. For love is a funny thing, you'll agree. Wherever my chicken goes, that's the place for me. And then when her dad replied, he'd nothing more to say. He grinned at me and said, now you're welcome, lad, to stay. So happy am I, and I haven't got a qualm. Now that 80 chicken's mine, and the chicken farm. De-o-de-lay, o-de-lee-de-lay, de-o-de-lee-de-lay. And then when her dad replied, he'd nothing more to say. He grinned at me and said, now you're welcome, lad, to stay. So happy am I, and I haven't got a qualm. Now that 80 chicken's mine, and the chicken farm.